So combining repertories with recent advances. I started going back and using more and more, and while the recent advances were being utilized, depending on the case in front of me, I found that I was on more sure footing. Once a case is approached by a method that highlights a remedy or a group of remedies from one family, row or class, one can further confirm the same through a quick repertorization. The repertorization can be done with the Kantian method that we are all more familiar with, without the need for a complete symptom. Now this is the difficulty with the Kent's repertory, that when we try to find a symptom which is exactly the symptom which is there in front of the symptom, even if it may be there in the repertory, it is very difficult. So just, you know, in that there are just one or two remedies, there's the risk of eliminating so many other remedies. On the other hand, the Bonninghausen, which is again on emphasis on generalization, it is the emphasis on the concomitant, which if it exists, one takes it, but because you don't get a concomitant, one tends to not feel that it is a complete rubric, and this becomes the challenge in Bonninghausen. So even if there is no concomitant, you generalize the case. As the symptoms come, you put the generals in, and in the end, when you see the whole picture stands out more clearly, as long as there is no emphasis on the hierarchy of symptoms, which means you don't necessarily go for the remedy that comes number one in the repertorial analysis, but as long as it is present in all the rubrics, you give importance to that. This I found very, very helpful. With this background,